Ci sono volte in cui a fare il mio mestiere si è piuttosto fortunati. Pensate un po', io oggi sono qui con Napoleon Murphy Brook, da una parte, grande musicista, compagno di Frank Zappa in mille occasioni, compagno di molti altri musicisti importantissimi, e dall'altra con un sacerdote del culto zappiano, ovvero Riccardo Fassi, ma soprattutto grandissimo musicista italiano, jazz e molto oltre il jazz, perché in realtà confinarti in quel genere sarebbe un po' poco. Molti vorrebbero essere al posto mio oggi, ma voi lo sarete in parte perché ascolteremo della eccellente musica, music, vedi come sono americano, musica fatta da questi due grandi musicisti. Prima di tutto, come vi siete incontrati? How do we met, you met, and began to play together?
Well, I think it was mostly done with Federico. Federico brought us together because he recognizes that he plays Zappa music and I'm the original with Zappa.
Yes.
And to put the two of us together would be a great collaboration. And the collaboration is important because he is mostly known for jazz,
Yes.
you know, but Zappa music is a combination of jazz, classical, rock and roll, doo-wop, rhythm and blues, everything,
Avant-garde,
even
many other things.
avant-garde, oh
Yes,
yeah,
that's
country music. But
everything.
most of all, it takes itself all come together and it returns into theater. You
That's
see, and
right.
this is farther beyond, this is more broad than just one genre of music. It includes all of them, and theater is like life, you see, because you recognize theater quite easily because it reminds you of something that you saw yesterday or you're doing today. And this is the important part, this is the important reason for us to collaborate together because we will take his knowledge of jazz, you know, and his knowledge of Zappa, and my just the knowledge of Zappa and my memory of
Yeah.
Zappa, and you know, it's what I do, it's what I live, and also with because he's a keyboard player, we also include the mastery of George Duke. You
Yes.
see, without George Duke,
One of the guys that he plays with, yeah.
absolutely, and I even do master classes, and the theme of my master class is my life and time with the masters, Frank Zappa
Yeah.
and George Duke, because they were the masters. Ask any keyboard player, and they would tell you George Duke is the master.
Yeah.
You ask any guitar player or any composer, and they would tell you that way beyond and over the top, and
Frank
much
Zappa was
better than anyone
there.
has ever been before in this lifetime that we live in now. That his name is Frank Zappa. And by the way, he's Italiano. Yeah, you know,
Yeah,
that
sure.
helps too, you know, that's not a
Senti, com'è
bad
suonare con questo simpatico ragazzo?
Molto emozionante perché lui ha questa autenticità, cioè lui è stato in mille avventure di Zappa, quindi ha proprio la sostanza vera di queste cose, cioè proprio assolutamente profondo.
Riccardo,
Quindi
per te era naturale muoverti in un ambiente, come dire, non soltanto jazzistico. In realtà io e te ci
assolutamente sì.
conosciamo da molti anni
Sì.
e so benissimo che, come dire, il jazz è parte fondamentale, centrale
Assolutamente.
della tua storia, ma molto altro ancora. Ma il tuo amore per Zappa com'è nato e quando è
È
nato?
nato da ragazzino ascoltando i dischi di Zappa, poi l'ho visto anche a Roma nei concerti che ci sono stati negli anni Ottanta e comunque mi ha sempre affascinato moltissimo. Cioè, ho sempre trovato una musica che va in ogni direzione, come dice lui, appunto, include tutta questa cosa, è bellissima. Cioè, assolutamente una ricchezza enorme. E adesso ritornandoci anni dopo si scopre che veramente c'è uno scrigno prezioso di cose che è una quantità di musiche incredibili che ha scritto e poi non si conoscono, alcune sono anche sparite, quindi è bello scavare, cercare e trovare le cose.
You made a record, ha fatto un disco intitolato Questo è quello che Frank Zappa ha ascoltato. You made a record, the title was This is what Frank Zappa
This is what Frank Zappa heard.
heard. And
Yes.
now, so how was that night?
Well,
È bello capire com'è stato, non tanto la musica, l'abbiamo sentita sul disco, ma com'è stato incontrare Zappa?
okay, I had a band from that I put together in San Jose, California, where I live, and we would go to Hawaii maybe 3 or 4 times a year to perform there for 2 or 2.5 months on each time we'd go. Frank Zappa just happened to be coming from Australia. He stopped in Hawaii because that's where his wife is from. Her parents live there. And then his road manager came out looking for something to do, and he saw this long line of people. And he came in and he saw me. He went and told Frank, "Wake up, because you need a new. You're looking for a lead vocalist, and I think I found him for you." And he
Right.
came to the club. Well, what I do is I would record every night. I would tape our music and listened to it that night before I went to bed. The next morning, play it for the musicians, and we would make sure it sounded better and better each time. Frank Zappa came in and listened to us for 2 hours, and he saw me playing saxophone, flute, dancing, singing lead
everything,
and background
yeah.
in the same song, and playing bongo drums yes. and keyboards. And he walked up to me after the end and he says, "Hello, my name is Frank Zappa and you're my new lead vocalist."
It was, many says it was really difficult to play with him because he was a very precise man, very careful by every single note and things like that. Was easy or difficult? Because you played with him so long, you must have learned something to make him happy every
well,
time.
Well, if you recognize what you're really dealing with, was it was the conservatory mm-hmm. of music by Frank Zappa. And so he dealt with it in that manner. It was discipline, but it was for perfection. But the perfection led to a theatrical performance that you would never yeah. forget. Because this is music that no one else, this music is so far ahead of its time, I don't think time has caught up with it yet. Time has still not caught up with yeah. this music. This is why every time another new genre of music comes along, like rap or hip hop or anything, and country music is rising again too, but they still do not reach the level of the music of Frank Zappa. Because it is so far ahead of his time. I actually believe he was from another planet.
Yeah.
But I think I'm from another
maybe
planet
you too.
Too. I
yes,
know it.
Maybe
but this is how he knew me, you know, before he knew me.
Yeah.
You know, he recognized me right away. He says, "I know you." And I said, "How could you know
me?"
He said, "I've been looking for you for a long time." I said, "But how could you be looking for me if we just met?" He says, "Don't worry. I know what I'm doing." So
what's
like
the
that.
Main difference between him and George Duke? I love George Duke a lot because he did so many wonderful music, but on a different kind of approach to music.
Yeah, well, George Duke was, he was a jazz piano player, mm-hmm. okay? Conservatory trained jazz piano player. He also played classical music. But with Frank, what happened to each one of us when we came to the Conservatory of Zappa, it broadened our horizons. It broadened our abilities. It made us what we did already better. It made what we did already more broad, mm-hmm. you know, and it didn't have any limitations. Before, there were limitations because we usually think about the classical conditioning that people say, if you don't do it like this, it's wrong.
Yeah, yes,
if
right.
you don't do it like this, it's wrong. You must do it like this, and it's right. Frank said, no, just do it.
Mm-hmm.
Do what you feel. He says, go along with what I'm doing. He says, take a chance. And this is what we did. And this is why there's no limitations.
Great. E la Tanchio Band come sta?
Anche bene, sta bene, sta lavorando per questo nuovo progetto.
Però faccelo sentire nel microfono.
Ah, certo, è vero, è vero. Allora, la Tanchio Band sta lavorando per il nuovo progetto di musica di Frank Zappa. Sto organizzando una serie di nuovi arrangiamenti dove poi ci saranno anche i pezzi che lui canterà. E quindi l'orchestra è sempre in movimento, cioè non si è mai fermata. Quindi poi la musica di Frank Zappa è un vestito che ci sta addosso proprio da tanto tempo e quindi ce l'abbiamo proprio come parte del DNA del gruppo, cioè proprio una cosa piuttosto naturale, una conseguenza naturale. Quindi il gruppo è sempre molto attivo e vivace.
Fantastico. Allora, signori, come dicevo all'inizio, è una giornata fortunata. Abbiamo qui per ascoltare dal vivo Napoleon Murphy Brook yeah. e Riccardo Fassi.
Can I say one more thing?
Yes, you
okay.
have to.
You asked me about the CD that I released called
yes.
This
mm-hmm.
is What Frank Zappa
yeah.
Heard.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what I did was I took that reel-to-reel recording and took it to Germany to specialists mm-hmm. who took the hiss and the noise, because you know tape
yes,
always
absolutely.
Had hiss and mm-hmm. noise. They took it out and they did the digital, but they didn't take away the analog sound of stereo. And I released the CD, so because a lot of people walk up to me and they said, "What were you doing when Frank Zappa met you?"
I was doing this.
This is what he heard. This
great.
Is what I did.
Great.
This was it. Then when he heard this, he says, "You're my new lead vocalist." Yeah. So everything on there is the resume, you know, that I needed to get the job as his lead vocalist. But what he really wanted me to do was to interpret his music.
Yeah, sure.
And to interpret it through animation and singing and dancing and acting, because that's what his music is, theater. But it's animated. You can't just stand there with your hands in your pocket.
No, absolutely.
And interpret the music of Frank Zappa. You have to do this, you have to do that, and you have to go this, and then sometimes this. Okay?
Great. So, it was a pleasure to have you here.
It's a pleasure. Thank you for having us.
E allora, spazio alla musica con Riccardo Fassi e Napoleon Murphy Brook.
Grazie. Thank you.
There will come a time when everybody who is lonely will be free to sing and dance and love. There will come a time when every evil that we know will be an evil that we can rise above. Who cares if hair is long or short or straight or partly gray? Do you know that hair ain't where it's at? There will come a time when you won't even be ashamed if you are fat. Wah, 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 wah. There will come a time when everybody who is lonely will be free to sing and dance and love. There will come a time when every evil that we know will be an evil that we can rise above. Who cares if you're so poor you can't afford to buy a pair of Mada Gogo stretch elastic pants? There will come a time when you can even take your clothes off when you dance. Wah, 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 wah. There will come a time when you can even take your clothes off when you dance. Wah, 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 wah. There will come a time when you can even take your clothes off when you dance. No, 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 no. The Muffin Man is seated at the table in the laboratory of the Utility Muffin Research Kitchen. Reaching for an oversized chrome spoon, he gathers an intimate quantity of dried muffin remnants and, brushing his scapula aside, proceeds to dump these inside of his shirt. He turns to us and speaks. Some people like cupcakes better. I, for one, care less for them. Arrogantly twisting the sterile canvas snoot of a fully charged icing anointment utensil, he poots forth a quarter ounce green rosette. Wait, let's try that again. He poots forth a quarter ounce green rosette near the summit of a dense but radiant muffin of his own design. Later, he says, Some people like cupcakes exclusively. While myself, I say, there is not, nor ought there be, nothing so exalted on the face of God's gray earth as that prince of foods, the muffin. Grazie.